Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and in this video, I want to talk to you about getting the Business Central Consultant Certification. This is a highly sought after certification, and I want to talk to you a little bit about what it means to take that test and try to pass it. Like, in other words, how can you prepare yourself for that? So first off, let's just make sure we're talking about the same thing, because there are a number of different Microsoft credentials. This one specifically is technically called the Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central Functional Consultant Associate Certification Exam. No joke, that is the full title, and it's often shorthand referred to as the MB-800. So that's kind of like the short code for that. And when we're talking about this exam, the first thing I need to say up front is that it is a difficult exam. It is, like I said, one of the most sought after certifications in relation to Business Central, and they have made it very difficult to take and pass. The silver lining is that the same day I'm releasing this YouTube video, I've also just released a full prep course to try to get people to the point where they can pass that exam. So I'll talk a little bit more about that prep course at the end of this video. But for now, let's talk a little bit more about the exam itself. In terms of questions and length, you're gonna get an hour and 40 minutes to take the test. And depending on the version of the exam you get, you'll have somewhere in the range of 40 questions. So you might get 42, you might get 49, et cetera. But the passing standard is to get basically 70%. They grade it on a point system, so it's 700 out of 1,000, but ultimately that comes out to basically 70% to get a passing standard on the exam. And the way they structure the test itself is they break it into these sections where you get a variety of different questions. So it's not like a lot of different exams you've probably taken where it's just straight up multiple choice questions. You're gonna get questions that ask you to go through entire case studies and answer relevant questions. You might get sequence questions where they give you many different steps, and you have to first off take the ones you think are correct and then resequence them into what you think is a proper pattern for whatever the solution is to the question that's being asked. Many, many different types of questions. And what makes this exam so difficult, there are a few things. First off, they cover such a wide range of topics that if you have a specialty or certain areas that you're good with, you're going to need to know many other subjects that you're probably not that familiar with. In addition to that, like I mentioned, there are many different types of questions. And then in those questions, I've seen really seasoned Business Central consultants asking themselves, what is this question even getting at? Just the wording they use, a lot of times they throw in trick questions, or it seems almost deliberately trying to confuse or hide what is the placement of the question. In other words, when you're doing a question, if you're doing a sequence of steps, how far in that sequence are you? Oftentimes they don't tell you, and they just expect you, based on the answers, to try to figure out exactly where you are in a sequence of steps. All of these resulting in you not only needing to have a really strong understanding of the system, but also a familiarity with answering these kinds of questions and taking this kind of test. So with that in mind, what are some of the resources you have available to you? Well, when it comes to Business Central, unlike a lot of other ERP systems, Business Central gives free trial access to Business Central. So if you have a work email or a student email, you can gain a 30-day trial, which is imperative for gaining that familiarity with the system, especially as you're learning and preparing for the test itself. So I highly recommend you take advantage of that. That is the number one most valuable resource you can have when preparing for a test like this. In addition to that, Microsoft technically has practice questions that they provide for free, but I would just straight up tell you they're completely useless. They do not reflect the kinds of questions you're going to get on the exam, the difficulty of questions, nor the format that you're going to be receiving questions on the final exam. So for all of those reasons, I would say they're gonna really trick you to think the exam is much easier than it actually is. So I would completely ignore the free practice questions. When you sign up for the exam, you can sign up and pay additional for these practice questions that they'll give you. They'll give you something like 100 or 200 practice questions up front, but you have to pay an additional $80. So it's up to you. If you've got if you can look at it and say, all right, that investment is worth it, the exam is $165 in US. So if you want to pay another $80 to get these valuable practice questions, by all means, take advantage of it. I know some people have a more limited budget. The exam is expensive enough as it is, so they might not be able to do that. So I wouldn't say the practice questions are vital, but if you can pay for them, they're definitely helpful to have. And then of course, as I mentioned earlier, there is the prep course that I just released. So the way that I organize this prep course, I basically look through all the various subjects that they cover in the exam and broke it up subject by subject, everything from order to cash, workflows, items and inventory, every one of these topics, I break it into a chapter and just walk through all the various things that you need to know about on that subject, including for every single topic, I go through practice questions at the end where I walk through how I would approach those questions and give you tips on how you can handle similar questions on the final exam. I also have an entire chapter at the beginning of the course that strictly addresses the exam itself. In other words, all the details about the exam, the types of questions you're gonna run into, and how best to handle those types of questions. Like I've alluded to earlier in this video, the exam requires not only a knowledge of the system, but also just kind of like the art of test taking. And there really is a skill to being able to navigate tests like these. So I'm gonna give you a bunch of different tips. And as I go through the practice questions, I'm gonna show you how to apply those tips on the real exam when you come across it. So if you have the money, obviously the course is not free. I've tried to price it reasonably, at least in relation to the final exam cost. But again, I know some people are gonna be able to take advantage of that, some are not. So if you have additional questions, you can always reach out to me by email. Hopefully, if you're able to take the course, I highly recommend. I know it's gonna be something valuable for you. I just released it, so I don't yet have a passing rate in terms of my students who have taken it and then gone on to pass the exam. But this is now the sixth prep course that I've made at this point. So I know how my students have done on other prep courses and the results have unanimously been very, very good. I have students reach out to me every single day telling me about how they've passed their certification exams on other ERP systems using my prep courses. So no doubt. In fact, this course is actually much longer than any other prep course I've done. I put a lot of work into it, so I know it's a good one. And even though this test is very hard and I can't guarantee that doing the prep course will allow you to pass the exam, I can tell you it's gonna give you a major leg up. So if you can take advantage of that, I'll have links down below. I'll also try to put a link up above. Please take a look at it and see if it's something that you can take advantage of. And with all of that in mind, if you're looking at taking an exam, truly, I wish you the best of luck and I hope to see you in the next video.